Hey, Blues fans, it's time for Tone Tuesday. This is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley. This week we're talking about the Planet Waves Auto Trim Tuning Machines. Some of you eagle-eyed viewers have spotted that these are not, in fact, the stock tuning machines that come on the beloved Stevie Ray Vaughan Strat. Yes, I had these put in place of the popular but problematic vintage tuners. I guess it depends on how satisfied you are with them. Now, there is one thing that you should know. I don't know how this relates to all Strats, but the shaft on these things, the hole that goes through the headstock here, is bigger than the shaft on vintage tuners for Strats. At least they were for the tuning machines that were on here. If you're going to install these yourself, you know, you're on your own. That's all I'm saying. Just make sure you're good with the drill and you know what you're doing. Anyway, the reason I picked these is because, number one, they have a higher turning ratio or tuning ratio, whatever it's called. Basically means that for each turn of your tuning peg with these, it changes the tension of your strings less. That does mean that you have to turn it more to accomplish the same amount of work, but it also means that when you get close to the right pitch, you have a lot more margin for error here. You can do a lot more finer adjustment. Basically, makes it easier to get your strings exactly in tune. The other thing that I like that I'll demonstrate in a minute is that they have an auto trim feature, which means that as you tune the string, it chops it off for you. So I'm going to demonstrate that for you now. But before I do that, we have to loosen the string to get it off. So how do you do that? Well, that's why we got to look at the back of the tuning machines, and you see these knobs, beautiful knobs here. Let me get the, what do I have, a 32. That would be my D string I'm going to replace. You just loosen the knob. Well, I tend to loosen the string first a little bit. Then you loosen this knob here a little bit. And what that does, if we go back to the front side again, that allows that allows this string to pop out of its hole right there. So if I put this back up here, you can see no extra. It was just going through here. And so as I take that string out, and let me show you the features of the tuning machine there. So when you're changing a string, and if you look closely in here, if you ever get a chance to use these, you'll see there's two holes. You got to make sure that you thread the string through the holes in a direction that makes it seem like it's going towards the thing, like down this way. Because the two holes go at an angle, the lower one will make it get chopped off on this little nub right here at the top. I don't know if I zoom all the way in, if you'll be able to see that or not. Get that exactly in focus. Can see where the string pops out here. There's a little nub right there. If I adjust my lights a little bit, maybe you'll be able to see that. But anyway, there's a little nub right there. And what you do is you pull this through, get most of your tension out, then you tighten down that bolt in the back just a little bit. Actually, tighten it down as tight as you can go with your fingers. And then you just turn the tuning peg, and watch this. This is like a thing of beauty. If you've ever been at a gig and you forgot your wire cutters and you had to change strings, what's about to happen is like a miracle. Look at that. Just trims it right off for you. And then what you do is you tune it up. You can see because they have the gears in the back, that locks the string into place. Well, it helps if you get it through the right slot in the nut here. Get that up to tune. What I found is that as you get it closer to tune, you got to go back and you got to tighten down that bolt in the back a little bit. But that's pretty much it. Like if you get good with this and you get one of those fancy string turning things, you can change your strings in minutes on a guitar like this. And if you've ever dealt with vintage tuners, like a string change can be, it can take a while. Maybe I'm just not very good at it, but it's always been problematic for me. that's why I like these tuning machines. I hope that informative and useful. And until next time, thanks for watching.